Welcome to the new file review process. In this video, we will learn how to create review stages in ZipForm Plus, which will allow for more automation, transparency, and process compliance within your brokerage than ever before. Hence, this new feature will greatly increase your productivity by providing a core location to manage review functions, allowing a full customization of the review process for a more realistic workflow, better communication, operational efficiency, accountability through creation of specific notification groups, and provide a solid overall structure of best practices developed through directional and equally customizable steps and guidelines. So let's start with defining what this new file review process feature is and how it compares to the previous. So out with the old and in with the new. Instead of the old system of sending transactions and documents out for review separately, which created an unnecessary number of steps, follow-ups, backtracking, and often limited status updates on both the side of the agent and the reviewer, with the new file review process, it can be broken into three simple stages, each with their corresponding folder, and customizable sequence of intelligent actions that smoothly carry the transaction from start to finish. So let's begin by covering the steps needed to activate this new feature and find out how easy it is to customize it. First, navigate to your broker settings, found just under the Admin tab on the navigation bar, and then under the General tab, switching on both New Compliance Review Stages and New Document Approval. It is important to note that once activated, this will turn off the classic approval flow, changing the approval widgets on the broker dashboard, and finally expanding the options in the template header on the navigation bar by providing a drop-down for Forms and Checklist, Review Stages, and Reviewer's Comments. Also, upon setting the switch for New Compliance Review Stages to on, the review stage workflows will be enabled for all locations in the brokerage. Finally, under Notifications, scroll down to the notification groups where we can create, edit, and delete the users we have chosen as reviewers in our ZipForm Plus account. The drop-down arrow will reveal the current members of each notification group created, including reviewers for listings. To create a new notification group, click on the plus icon just next to Create Notification Group. This will immediately open up a list of all users within your brokerage. From here, you will type in the desired name of your new notification group, and select which users you would like to add to it. Finally, click on the Save button at the bottom of the Users menu. If desired, at any point you can edit your notification group by clicking on the editing pencil icon on the right. Also, the delete icon is just to the right of it. Now let's move on to viewing, editing, and creating a review stage. Review stages are located under the templates header on the navigation bar just below forms and checklists. First, let's take a look at an existing review stage, and then we will see how to create one of our own. To open, you can either select the drop-down in the top right-hand corner of the review stage, or simply double-click on it. Once open, notice that this particular review stage has a total of three steps, with the last two actually being alternate steps contingent upon the outcome of the first. Notice inside of the listing stage, the first step, named Listing Needs Review, contains the following actions. We call the first action a trigger, as it sets the process in motion, meaning once the agent marks a folder for review and the stage is selected inside of the transaction, it will automatically trigger the next action that has been selected, which in this case is notifying the assigned notification groups. Once the notification group has received and reviewed the agent's submitted folder for the transaction, they will then either mark the folder as approved or not approved. It is from here that the final step of this stage is determined. If approved, this broker has chosen that the listing approved step be automatically applied, containing its own set of actions, including changing the transaction status, in this case, to active, and automatically the apply template action, which contains the corresponding folder for the next stage. Lastly, the end review stage action must be added, so that upon completion, the next stage can be applied. If not approved, the listing not approved step will be applied. The transaction status will be automatically changed in this case to inactive, and it will not be advanceable to the next stage until all documents within the review folder have been approved by the reviewer, requiring the agent to make the necessary corrections and resubmit the folder for review. Now let's create our own review stage. Click on the plus new button on the far left-hand side. Enter the desired name. In addition, you can set the scope to either global, which represents the entire brokerage, or office, which will allow you to specify which office to share the use of your review stage with. Once finished, click on Save. Now click on the plus add step button. Then click on the top area to name the step. Notice in creating a trigger, it is really setting the approval status that acts as a trigger for the subsequent steps to begin. Let's select Needs Review in the dropdown. Next, we need to select who to notify by clicking on the Notify button. We want to select how we wish to notify the recipient, either through email or inside of ZipForm Plus. Next, select our recipients either based on role and/or notification group we've created, with an optional message. Click on Save. Lastly, we can set the transaction status. Let's start with inactive. For our second step, we will once again click on the plus sign, naming the step Listing Approved, and the plus add trigger button. This time for a trigger, setting the folder to approved status. This will then be set to notify the appropriate notification groups, and set the transaction status to active, and also to apply the necessary template containing the folder for the subsequent stage to be applied, in this case, the sales stage. From here, this listing stage can be ended by selecting In Review Stage. This will enable the agent's transaction to move to the sales stage, also consisting of its own trigger action steps and status setting, and if this too is approved, finally on to the closing stage. In the event the agent submitted folder is not approved by the assigned notification group, our third or alternate step we will name Listing Not Approved. This time for a trigger, setting the folder to Not Approved in the dropdown. Hence, as mentioned before, the transaction will not be advanceable to the next stage until all documents have been approved by the notification group. Now let's move to the Forms and Checklists area. Select Forms and Checklists under the template header on the navigation bar. Here we can quickly build an appropriate folder of forms, and even checklist if preferred, to be a potential part of our listing review stage, our sales review stage, or our closing review stage. We do this in the same manner as creating a template, by clicking on the plus new button on the far left. Select the template type, again creating a name, selecting our category, setting our scope, and moving to our auto apply options. It is important to note that it is only the first template prior to the review stages that needs to be set as auto-apply. All subsequent templates will be applied automatically by simply adding them as an action step in the creation of the review stage. We'll also set our compliance options, choosing either to allow agents to edit and delete items applied from the template, or not by selecting No. Finally, we can select to auto-apply a template to the one we are creating right now, if desired. Now let's add the related forms. Over to the right, click on the All Forms tab and select the desired forms. To keep things organized, we will create a folder to hold the executed versions of those forms. Click on Add Folder at the top and name it Final Listing Folder. Lastly, as a reminder for the agent, we can utilize placeholders, naming them after those forms. Click on Add Doc on the far left, Create Placeholder, utilize the standard name, search for the forms being used in your library, switch to Yes if required, then click OK. To move the placeholders to the Final Listing folder, left-click and hold, and drag them to the Final Listing folder. As a reminder again, it is important to note that as an alternative, the broker does have the option to map the review folder to the desired stage in advance when first creating the template. In doing so, this will assure that the agent will not select the wrong stage when submitting the folder for review. To do this, click on the top right-hand corner of the Review folder. Then select Apply Review Stage. Choose the desired review stage and simply click Apply. Lastly, for setup, we can create our own reviewer's comments, which we can use as canned comments when we review the agent submitted documents. It is located just under the review stages under the template header. By clicking on the plus new button and entering the name of the canned comment you wish to store, and lastly choosing if you want to share it globally or with a specific office, then click on Save. You can double-click on any reviewer's comment to add a more detailed comment to it. Now that we have everything built, let's see the review process in action. In our story, Jeff's seller has agreed to work with Dean Agent on selling his home. Dean Agent now creates a new transaction by clicking on the plus new button on the far left, categorizing as a new listing, naming the transaction, selecting the type, and also noticing that the listing folder template is already queued to be auto-applied to the transaction. Then clicking on Save. Notice currently no stage has officially been applied yet, as Dean Agent still needs to have the form signed, received back, and submitted for review. So let's fast forward to see what his key steps are as an agent in creating the signing packet. Dean Agent will start by selecting the e-sign icon in the top left-hand corner. Now selecting the forms that were auto-applied to the transaction earlier to send out for signing, Here he can create a packet name, select the signing service, and most importantly, the return folder. He will want to select the folder that was created and applied by you, the broker, the final listing folder. Once selected, he will click on Next to the far right. Then select the parties, and then Closing. For the next step, he'll click on the Next button to the right. This moves Dean Agent to the design phase, in which case both forms are pre-tagged for signatures. Dean Agent now clicks on the Send Invitations button. Once the forms have come back signed, they will go straight to the return folder assigned to them. And Dean Agent will now submit the folder for review by clicking on the review stamp in the bottom right-hand corner, which will mark all documents contained in it for review. Once he clicks on Next to the far right, he will then select the review stage and add additional comments if desired. Finally, clicking Apply. As you will see shortly, working hand-in-hand with new features to streamline file review, the review stage lets both the agent and the reviewer know how a transaction is progressing. Now let's take a look on the reviewer's side at a more streamlined functionality in the review process. Going back to the reviewer account, now let's move over to the broker dashboard. Notice a slight difference in the layout. Now we can view transactions that need approval, transactions that have been rejected for the purpose of follow-up, and tasks that need approval. To view Dean Agent's recently submitted transaction, click on Transactions that need approval. To activate the rapid review feature, click on the transaction name. As a reviewer, here this feature will allow us to review all documents, add comments, and set the approval status all in one screen. Without having to visit the agent's transaction, you can also see at the top right that all of the placeholders have been filled. So let's begin by scrolling through the documents and performing our review process. Noticing the plus cursor, at any point when we find an error, we can left-click, type in a new comment, or a canned comment from the drop-down, finally marking the document as not approved. Lastly, at the top left, click on Save and Notify. Here you can add comments, send notifications daily, and also send via SMS. The other documents can be quickly marked by clicking on the Needs Review button and marked accordingly. Dean Agent notices the current status of the stage shown both in the Transactions List view and in the Transaction Summary screen, labeled as Listing Not Approved. Dean Agent now corrects the errors and resubmits. The broker reviews the documents again. This time approving by clicking on the Change All Needs Review to Approved box. Dean Agent notices that the transaction review stage is now marked as Listing Approved, enabling him to now move from the listing stage to Sales Activities, which includes the corresponding folder to be completed, signed, and submitted for review in the same manner. As mentioned from the beginning, there are typically only three stages, but you do have the option to add as many as you desire. Some additional features to the new file review process include being able to now filter transactions by review stage in the Transactions List page, and Deep Link. Upon receiving an approval notification email, clicking on the link to review the transaction will launch you into the Rapid Review screen for that transaction, hence minimizing steps and maximizing efficiency. That concludes this video on the new file review process. Be sure to connect and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, and YouTube. Thanks for watching.